הגעתי לעבודה, יום של ערב פורים.
When the bomb took place, I was with my wife in Jerusalem.
אני עשיתי את העבודה בבית ו...
What happens? It was around 2:30 in the afternoon.
עבדתי עם שואב אבק, ובגלל הרעש של השואב, לא שמעתי אם מישהו דפק בדלת, או מישהו צלצל, או... לא שמעתי כלום. אז כשפתחתי את הדלת, יצאתי למדרגות פה, ראיתי שיש משלוח מנות. ממש היה נראה רגיל לחלוטין. הוא היה עטוף בניילון אדום, שגם כן היה אפשר לראות מה יש בתוך המשלוח, מה יש בפנים. אז ראיתי חטיפים ושוקולדים, סוכריות, ועליתי לקומה שנייה, אז אני אמרתי לו, מישהו הביא משלוח מנות בשבילכם, וישב ליד השער. בפנים, בחדר מדרגות, ואני לקחתי את הזבל, סקית של הזבל, וירדתי למטה בחוץ. הגעתי לפח השפע, פתחתי את הפח השפע, זרקתי את הזבל. פתחתי את הדלת, כניסה.
Here, the bomb, the package was here, and it blew right through the table. So the other side is missing, it destroyed the other part of the table. But this is the part we have. And the blast was so strong, it destroyed the tiles in the bottom, took off pieces of his toes, and then the bomb went up and made a hole through the ceiling and destroyed the whole apartment.
אבל זה היה כלום. לעומת מה שראיתי אחר כך. ראיתי את עמי על הרצפה, שוכב. בין העמוד, הוא היה על הרצפה, שוכב על הגב שלו.
Arrived at the hospital, we were told that his life was in danger, and that he had to go in for an operation, but he might not make it through the operation. We had to identify him, and my husband identified him.
I didn't recognize him. His face was so swollen. He was so burnt. And when I saw him, you can see all this exposed. All this was exposed. You saw muscle, blue, green, off-white. You saw the kneecap. You see a hole here. You can see the lung breathing.
Then they took him in for an operation. It took 8 hours. Here, there's, they call it anush, which means that the spirit is leaving the body. And most people don't come back to life in that condition.
The eye was slightly out. And I said to myself, how could that person ever see? The eye full of blood and coming down here, the glass when the windows broke, it opened up here, and the doctor explained to us he didn't sever the two main arteries. So they put staples here. Here there were pieces missing. There were holes. Over here, there's no skin. What it is the muscle. And they had to peel him like a potato and cover his legs over here. If we could see, this is his arms. and he had screws and bolts, metal all over. And that they took out some metal, but they said these metals will stay. They can't take them out. Police and the secret police. And they said, do you know who did this? Honestly, I said, maybe it was the Palestinian attack. He says, no. You've been attacked by a religious Orthodox radical group.
"그렇습니다. 아미네 가정은 이스라엘에서 예수를 믿는 메시아닉 주 가정입니다. 이들을 메시아닉 주 또는 믿는 자들이라고 부르죠. 현재 이스라엘엔 약 500만 명의 유대인들이 살고 있는데 그 중에서도 약 10%의 유대인이 유대교의 율법과 전통을 고수하며 살아가고 있습니다. 이들을 정통 유대인 또는 종교인이라고 부르죠. 이들은 예수를 하나님의 아들로 인정하지 않을 뿐만 아니라 같은 유대인으로서 예수를 믿는 사람을 배격하고 있는 것이죠.
And all of a sudden, the rabbi shows up at night with his associates. But at the end, he tells me, if you ever preach the gospel out of this house, I'll make so much trouble for you, you would not know where to go. What happened, we have the bombing a year before that. Four men came to my house, to the door, and they were dressed up like religious people, and they took my picture. Later on, it was in the posters. The posters had my name, address. Here's a poster that says, residents of Ariel, be careful. There's people making believe they're Jewish, masquerading as Jews. Don't give them a chance, and it says stay Jewish. It's in Hebrew and Russian. And here is the here are the pictures of the believers here. Now, what did this poster do? This poster let everybody know that there were Messianic Jews here, that there was a church here.
And these were passed out every 4 to 6 months. They were put on all the windshields of the cars. They were put into all the post office boxes, and they were put on the bus stations from here, 45 kilometers to Tel Aviv.
My telephone here, I have a private number, because now, as you know, if somebody gets on the computer, they can see where I am. There's a program on the computer, they can see where I'm at. With me, what they'll probably do is put a bomb underneath my car, so I have to check the car every day underneath, or by my telephone, they can see when I'm out of Ariel. They'll follow me and shoot me. So I think those are the best options they have. We have to be careful in a meeting that they don't throw in a grenade, because the power of a grenade will knock down the wall.